Hi everybody, welcome back to the AutoPot YouTube channel. My name is Pat and today we are setting up the Mother Nature CO2 Generator. So what I have here today is the Mother Nature CO2 Generator from AutoPot. We want to show you guys exactly how to set it up and get it going so that way you have the proper CO2 in your grow room. Before we get going, as you can see with my CO2 in here, I'm about 620. Ambient, so it's not bad. I'm looking to get higher, 800 to 900 with this bucket. Let's get this thing set up and see what we can do. First things first, what came with our bucket? We're doing a 10 liter because I got the 4x8 behind me here. You have the 5 liter bucket that is for the 4x4, and you have the 10 liter bucket, which I have here, which is for up to an 8x8. You get your tubing, which you're gonna need to connect to your pump, and you're gonna get your little connector pieces that you're gonna need to go from your generator to the tubing so you can have your little quick disconnect. Don't lose these. They usually tend to be wrapped up within something in the box, so can be easily lost, but just don't let that happen. And then let's see inside here. You have your ingredients that we're gonna activate. So we're gonna open this up in just a second and get to it. You have 24 hours to get this thing activated. So once I have my water's hot now, I wanna get this done. Get it activated while the water is warm, and then we'll go through the little intricacies and little things that you need to do to make sure this thing is running properly the whole time. What I'm gonna do is I am going to look right inside this bucket here and to make sure there's no kinks going to my airstone. So everything looks nice and straight, nice and happy. So I am going to cut this bag open and get this stuff in here so that way we can get going on this. Last time I cut it open all the way and I felt like I made a mess. This time I'm gonna try and dump it a little. So. Now as I'm dumping this in, the one thing I wanna make sure when I'm done is I don't kink. So everything's in there. As you can see, all the active ingredients are in there. Making sure that my tubing is not kinked at all in the bottom. This is our 10 liter, so this one gets 2.5 liters of hot water, not boiling, hot water, which we have right here. And if you're doing the 5 liter, that one gets 1/3 of a gallon, which is about 1.5 liters. So, but let's dump this in here and get it closed and we'll go through some stuff. So, yeah, some hot water here. I don't know how many people have used these pourers before, but they always pour out the bottom. There's always a drip coming out there. It drives me crazy. It's nice and warm. Now you need it to be warm. If it's not warm, it's not gonna activate. So, and make sure you get the right amount in there. So there's 2 liters and there's our 1/2 liter. Awesome, cool. We're gonna throw our top back on. And at this point, it's a waiting game. You have 24 hours before you wanna turn this thing on. In the meantime, let's go over some other things to make sure everything is running properly. So let's show you the two connections within here. Well, this is charged for the next 24 hours. So you have two tube lines going in. This one goes right into your air hose, and this is the one that you're gonna connect to your air pump. It's pretty easy. I already have it set up behind me, but just to show you in front of me, it's pretty simple. You wanna get your tubing however much length you have. And here, I'm just gonna cut off a small sample size. You put it on your pump, and then you'll use your little connector things, little quarter inch connectors, and you'll just attach one to here and one to here. I mean, that's it. That's how simple it is. That's how simple it is to just get it hooked up. And then this one here, this is the one that's gonna be going to your fan, because you really do want a fan to distribute the CO2 throughout your tent. That's the basic setup on how you do it. And then you have people say, well, how do I run it? Do I run it all the time? Do I run it here? Do I run it there? Either way, when you're running this, you just want to run it during the day. So your first option is to run it with a timer and to run it 15 minutes on and 60 minutes off. throughout the light cycle, and that'll do what you need to do. It's more of a pulsating method, but it makes it work for the way this thing has been set up. By doing it this way, you get high concentrations ejected in hourly, and it tends to work very well. Your other option for running this is attach your pump to a CO2 sensor. So anytime your levels would drop below 650 during the day, this pump will kick on. They would generate to, I would say, probably 850, 900, and then it's gonna kick back off. Those are your only two options. If you run it during the day constantly 24 hours a day or 12 hours the whole time the light's on, it's not gonna work right, and you may end up running across some issues. You definitely want circulation within the tent. So if you don't have fans moving around and this is pulsating out the CO2 through here, and it's little bits coming out, without the circulation in the tent, it's just gonna, CO2 falls. It's not gonna like fall like crazy, but it is gonna fall. So you wanna have the circulation. That's why I definitely recommend putting this behind a small fan to put up to rise above the canopy. It's gonna be your best bet for sure. Another thing to think about is once you get this set up, do not take the lid off. It's building pressure in there, and it's creating, it's nice and warm, and it's doing its thing. It's creating its CO2, so you don't want to take it off. You don't want to go anywhere. Just let it do its thing. Another thing you want to think about when running this is not having an exhaust. So if you're running a tent, if you're running a room, and you have an exhaust that pulls out, pull out during the evening. Don't pull out during the day when you run the CO2, or you're just gonna be, once again, wasting your money. And another thing is, when you open these tents up, like I have here, it's gonna let out everything. You're gonna be sitting back to your ambient. You know, and my ambient's right around 620, 640. Looks like I'm blowing up the CO2 in here a little bit. We're up to almost 700 for me yapping away, but that's okay, that's completely normal. We still wanna get it up higher, so we're gonna give it 24 hours, get it set up, and today we're just running this in an empty tent. So it'll show you that even with this empty space, this thing's still gonna work, it's still gonna get up to where we need it to be. And on top of the kinks in here that we're making sure there are no kinks, if you're like, man, this thing is not blowing out any CO2, make sure there's no clogs. Now, you shouldn't have any, this is a brand new setup. Honestly, there really is zero reason you should have any clogs, but you never know, someone could have dropped something and maybe the end landed some dirt and you didn't realize it was the top of a pot. So just keep an eye on that. Just make sure everything's clean and set up, no kinks, no clogs, and you're gonna be happy with your CO2. So now if you have this whole thing set up and you're like, man, I'm not getting the CO2 levels I need, maybe it sat around for a while, or heck, maybe it's cold, or maybe you just didn't have warm enough water. The one thing you can do is you can open your lid back up, add another 250 mils of hot water, and give it another 24 hours and turn it on again. That is the way to reactivate it if by chance you ran across yourself in a position where it's not activated anymore. So here's our one going to our pump. We'll run this one here. This one's gonna run out. We're gonna use our quarter inch on this side, and our quarter inch on the other side, which is gonna go to our fan. Make sure everything is no kinks. So we're gonna follow it up here. I personally have mine ran right at the side, right into a nice little 6-inch fan, ran right into the back to give ourselves a nice flow over the canopy. It's essential to having these fans. If you don't have a fan, you're not blowing around as much as you'd like to. But as you can see, should be no problem getting the CO2 out there. All right, let's plug this in. It's been 24 hours. This tube. We're gonna plug right to there. It immediately went over the chain. So we know this guy's bringing it in. Okay, so we let the CO2 go crazy in there. As you saw, we made the alarms go off. So now what we did is we let that room air out. We turned off the CO2. We then, once it got back to ambient, that 600, I went ahead and closed up the tent, plugged in the CO2, plugged it into the fan, and walked away. But as you can see now, we're sitting at 882, 883. Which is exactly what I'm looking for off of what I set up in here. And now this is gonna set me up for the next 6 months. And that's how long these bucket refills should last. And after 6 more months, I will have used my refill, and that's a year's worth of CO2. So as you can see, we are all set up. Our CO2 is up there. We are now over 850. Everything is working properly. Thank you for watching our Mother Nature CO2 generator setup.